Early German versions of a one-man machine gun failed because the powerful 8x57 round produced uncontrollable recoil during automatic fire. Designers solved that problem with a round halfway between a rifle cartridge and pistol ammunition. The STG-44 fires a 7.92 by 33 millimeter cartridge, said to maintain precision in full automatic mode.
Okay, to test the effectiveness of the STG-44, we've got a mock-up street. I'm gonna engage targets at each station and on the move, finishing at a motorized torso target. I have to hit that target before it hides behind that wall over there. What's this called again?
Sturmgewehr 44.
That's just fun to say. You got the time?
I do.
All right, let's do it.
Rock and roll. Ready.
Going hot.
Go.
With this new breed of weapon, soldiers can lay down a full magazine of automatic suppressive fire in seconds. It's quick and easy to reload, and switching back to semi-automatic mode gives you the precision you need in a rifle. The intermediate cartridge maintains the power of a rifle up to 300 yards. One final target, and this test is done.
Clear. Nice shooting, Will.
Check it out. Clear weapon. Thanks.
Okay. I think you got him.
This is an effective weapon. Because the round's so short,
yeah,
the recoil is nice and short as well, which makes it easy to control any kind of muzzle flip or anything like that. You can reassess your targets very easily, and it worked out real well. So typically, where would this weapon be employed?
When the Germans invaded Russia, what they noticed was that they were up against entire Russian units that were all outfitted with a PPSH, which had a 70-round drum and fired, 800 rounds a minute, and it was very easy to maintain. And you go up against that with bolt-action rifles, you're dead.
Mm-hmm. So what you have is a necessity-based evolution into an automatic weapon.
Exactly right.